Greetings, members one and all of the Salivation Nation. Silver plunges over a dollar and gold is down. Let's find out why. Yes, here's the prices staring at us right in the face. The recording of this video, we are seeing an unexpected move, I believe, in the metals prices. And when we saw a little bit of a decline after the turbulence, after the coronavirus new strain that was discovered in the UK. But let's see here. This article from MarketWatch, it talks about how it's the sharpest one-day slide in gold in 2 weeks. And silver, probably even more so, down a full dollar. Gold futures on Tuesday logged their first consecutive losses in about 2 weeks, marking the steepest slide for the metal since early December as a perkier U.S. dollar and an attempted rebound in equities kept the metal haven or the haven metal under selling pressure in the session. And so, yes, indeed, fascinating to see this movement here. A stronger dollar can be a headwind for asset priced in the currency like precious metals. Meanwhile, stocks were trying to recover from volatile trading on Monday that was sparked by worries about a more transmittable new strain of coronavirus spreading from the United Kingdom. And this article here from Kitco talks about how they were lower in midday U.S. trading pressure on Tuesday, pressured by profit taking from recent gains by short and the shorter term futures traders. The key outside markets are bearish for the metals on this day, higher US dollar index and lower crude oil prices. Also, global stock markets have somewhat stabilized Tuesday after hitting some fresh COVID turbulence on Monday, somewhat reducing risk aversion. So February gold futures were last down $12.50 at 1870.50. So a good dip on gold when many people are very bullish on gold and silver too. And silver is actually down over a dollar from its high. Global stock markets were mixed overnight with Asian shares mostly down and European shares mostly firmer. U.S. stock indexes were weaker at midday. The global marketplace is still a bit edgy following the weekend news of a newly discovered and more easily transmissible strains of COVID-19 in the United Kingdom. Several countries have banned travel to and from Britain. Some health experts said they believe the current COVID vaccines would be effective on the new mutation of the virus. However, it's too soon to tell if the current COVID vaccines will be as effective on the new strain as on the original form of the virus. Reports overnight said that the UK and the European Union may be getting closer to on reaching a smooth Brexit agreement. So I think that as well is having an impact in a positive direction for metals, or negative direction for metals, really, because they're going down. The dollar index is higher at midday on a corrective rebound this week after hitting a 2.5-year low last week. The other important outside market sees February NYMEX crude oil futures prices lower and trading around $47.25 a barrel. The yield on the benchmark 10-year U.S. Treasury note futures is currently trading at 0.92. We won't go into the technicals that he usually does here on the metals, but it's very interesting news indeed. And again, as I've mentioned in my video about being bullish for silver in the coming year, I think that pretty much extends with an understanding that we're going to see situations like this where the metals have pullbacks, but $25 silver is still pretty good, I think, in comparison to kind of where it was earlier in the year and also earlier and also last year, especially back in March when it was under $12 an ounce. We also have to take into account this situation, you know, that the silver markets are choppy during holiday trading. We have very thin volume. Ultimately, the market is going to continue to see noisy behaviors. That's kind of part of what it's about. Silver markets have been very choppy during the trading session on Tuesday as we continue to trade thin volume. After all, it is a holiday week, and therefore, We have little in the way of volume, and this means that the markets can get thrown around quite a bit. That being said, the market seems to have support underneath, especially near the $26 level, which sits right around the 50-day EMA, which sits right around the $24.50 level. And long-term, short-term pullbacks will probably continue to be bought into as a market could go looking towards the $28 level eventually. And so I think that's a pretty fair analysis, something that we do see typically as we head out and finish out the year. We'll see markets continue to move in this regard. So something to consider there. Gold is still pretty high when you take into account that gold, was well under $1,700 not too long ago. And so these are still very high prices, I believe, for both these metals, considering their recent performance in the past 5 years. And I believe we will continue to see them go up in the next year. So my predictions really don't change the calculus where we're at. This is just kind of a little bump in the road, so to speak, on its downward direction, and provides a buying opportunity in my mind. But nonetheless, it is something to take into account, and things can change on a dime. This is one of those years, and I believe next year will prove to be volatile as well. And we may see, who knows? Who knows where things could go? I think most analysts are bullish for gold and silver in the next year, but we can't rule out the possibility that we may see a bear market, or at least a kind of a tepid market. A lukewarm market for the precious metals. We'll see how it plays out. Nonetheless, very interesting indeed to see where the metals prices are right now. And I actually did take advantage of the dip here, but we'll see how it plays out. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Is this something you're watching closely? Now, obviously, as stackers, and I do at times talk about the day-to-day price movements for gold and silver, but I never really live and die by these movements. We buy to protect ourselves against economic instability, and doing as such, we only just look for opportunities, but are not really affected by these daily price movements. It's kind of fun to talk about, to kind of see where the psychology is on this. But nonetheless, other than that, we just press on, and that's what we do as holders of precious metals and buyers too. So I'd like to extend a multitude of gratitude to you all for taking the time to watch this video, and encourage you to please rate, share, comment, and subscribe.